When dealing with a report with a significant number of records, there are multiple filtering options available within Inforiver. To start, I'm going to come up to the Home ribbon and select the filter icon. Come over and select Add Filter. This dropdown on the left will let you filter by either your row or column hierarchies or any of your calculations as well. As an example, let's start by selecting sales. Now notice that the comparison values here did change when I went from category to sales. The options in here will be dependent on the type of data that you have in the selection over on the left. So we're going to select less than, and I'm going to type in 10,000. Notice that all of the values in the table instantly changed, so it immediately applied the filter. Now it's important to note that this filter is applying at the visual level, so the data that you see in front of you is what's going to get filtered. As an example, if I applied that same filter of less than 10,000 using the filters pane on the sales amount column from the fact table, this is the result that I would get because it's filtering against the original data on rows in the actual data model itself versus filtering at the visual level. So an important distinction between how InfoRiver would filter versus the standard filters pane. You also have an option to disable all if you want to temporarily turn off the filters as you're creating these. Now let's come to the advanced options and see what other options we have available. Besides the ability to add additional filters, we also have the option to add groups. I'm going to select Add Group. Notice that a new group section was added at the bottom. So to start, I'm going to have brand name is, and again taking a look at these comparisons, which are now based on text values because brand name is a text data type, and if you select an option, you'll actually be given a dropdown of all available values from that column. I'm going to scroll down and select Wide World Importers, and within this group, I can now select Add Filter. Now, by default, within this group, we're going to have an AND statement in here. So let's change this to a different column of category and is, select the dropdown, scroll down, audio. So now you'll notice that the couple of filters have been applied. For sales is less than 10,000, brand name is Wide World Importers, and category is audio. Now, a really powerful feature of InfoRiver is the ability to change this to an OR statement, which is not something natively available in Power BI because brand name and category are from two different dimension tables. And native slicers and the filters pane cannot do OR statements across different columns. Change that to OR. Notice that now the rows are showing where brand name either is Worldwide Importers or where the category is audio. And we can observe that for Northwind Traders that also contains audio category sales. And this grouped set of OR filters is still being combined with an AND statement with sales of less than 10,000. And last but not least, the persist filters means that any filters applied either in the basic or advanced filter menu will remain consistent when you publish this to the Power BI service, where users will consume this report in reading view.